Sophie, always screaming and yelling about something. And it gets real bad at him. Mother, because they're serving your dinner, because what? Polenta again? The polenta is cornmeal wash. But if you make it the right way, we can be able to get a nice spaghetti sauce on it, and some rabbit or some chicken. I think it's absolutely delicious. So this guy was complaining, which is really quite understandable, because I believe in them every single day. But anyway, John Bosco did care for these young children and suffered greatly for them. But one of his biggest things was to always show mercy, try to be kind to them, and not get in their face. Even St. Gregory, the great in his writings, talks about how to deal with different people. And sometimes with the arrogant, the proud, the noisy, you have to deal with the gentle. And sometimes with the people who are too timid, you need to be a little bit strong. So he uses virtue and how to put in some of the same virtues we heard today in the letter to the Philippians, that be modest and holy, think of things that are lovely and virtuous, and any praise of discipline is how to live his life. So he's told himself in that same day. How many souls did he save by taking care of? So for us today, this is our call as well. When we look at little children, they have absolutely no power. They're helpless. And in some parts of the world, the helpless are even more extreme. You're going to see commercials over the Super Bowl about sex trafficking children these days, particularly during this time of the year. It happens in many more places in the world than it does in the United States, because they're now being manipulated by the government for the human individual. Who are the greatest in the kingdom of heaven are taken care of. If you want to see a child being taken care of, you can see the picture up there of St. Joseph holding the child Jesus. The creature is holding his creator and teaching him all the good things in life that we need to know. We need to do that for the children of our own lives as well. And then for ourselves, to revert, not to become childish or childlike in the sense of having that trust before the Lord, to know that we're being taken care of. The child doesn't worry about anything, they always get paid the rent. Most children are have that taken care of, particularly for this country, and that's how we should live. And we live like that before God, and we know He's taking care of us as well. Then we begin to think of things that are for the Lord, and the early Philippians, and we can rejoice all of us.
Thank you. Oh, Thank you.